I remember it was in the Greek descent. Each serpent dying and rot its ghost upon the wall. Eagerly I wished to borrow, vainly. I had sought to borrow from my books. Surcease of sorrow. Sorrow for the lost ruler. The rare and grieved of the maiden who the angels made the Lord. Names of the Lord. And the silver, sad, uncertain rustling of each purple curtain filled me and touched the dirt never felt before. To still the beating of my heart, I stood at the entrance. Some visitor intruding entrance of my chamber door. Some late visitor intruding entrance of my chamber door. This is what I presently, my soul grew stronger, hesitating then no longer. Sir, said I, or madam, truly your forgiveness I implore, but the fact is I was napping, and so gently rapping and so faintly you came tapping at my chamber door, that I was scarce sure I heard you. Here, I opened wide the door. The darkness, nothing more. Deep into the darkness, peering long, I stood there wandering, fearing, doubting, dreaming dreams, no mortal and a damned dream. Silence was unbroken. This came no tell me, the only word there spoken was the whispered word. The silence. And the voice echoed the word. And then this, and nothing more. Back into the chamber turning, all my soul within me burning. Soon again, I heard a tapping, something louder than before. Surely, said I, surely, that is something at my window lattice. Let me see then what that is. End this mystery, explore. Let my heart be still a moment. End this mystery, explore. Open it. I flung the shutter. When? And the first flutter in this, the stately rain, the saintly days of yore. Not the least of this is here. Perched above my chamber door, perched upon a bust of glass, just above my chamber door, perched and sat. Then, this ebony bird beguiling my sad fancy to smiling by the great stone door, countenance forth. Though thy crest be short and shaven, thou, I fear not shorn or craven, ghastly, grim, and ancient raven, wandering from the nightly shore, tell me what thy lordly name is upon the night's Plutonian shore. Quoth the raven, the moon. Much I marveled this ungainly fowl to hear discourse so plainly, though its answer little meaning, little relevancy bore. For we could not have the wind, or living human being ever yet was blessed with seeing bird above his chamber door, bird or beast upon the sculptured bust. Just above his chamber door, but such a name as that the moment. But the raven, still lonely and not passing dust, spoke only that one word as if his soul in that one word did not know. Not his father had he uttered, but he fell, muttered, till I, scarcely had he muttered, other words. We shall leave the room for the hopes of the night. The birds said that the Lord started at the stillness broken by reply, so aptly spoken. Doubtless, said I, what it utters is its only stop and store. Caught from some unhappy master, an unmerciful disaster, following fast and followed faster, till the songs one burden bore, till the dirges of his hope that melancholy burden bore, of never, never more. But the raven, still beguiling all my soul into smiling straight. I wheeled a cushioned seat in front of Bird and passed the door. Then, upon the velvet sinking, I betook myself to fancy unto fancy thinking. What this ominous bird of war, what this weird, unwilling, gas, rot, and ominous bird of war meant in croaking nevermore. This, I sat engaged in guessing, but now simply expressing. This and more I sat whining with my head against the pine and the cushioned velvet lining that the lamp might not have. But whose velvet violet lining with the lamp like melting on? She shall bless. Methought the air grew denser, perfumed by some unseen senses, swung by Seraphim, whose footfalls tinkled on the tufted floor. Wretch, I cried, thy God hath lent thee, by these angels he hath sent thee respite, respite and nepenthe from thy memories of Lenore. Quaff, O quaff, this kind nepenthe, and forget the lost Lenore! Prophet, said I, thing of evil, prophet still, if bird or devil, whether tempest sent or whether tempest tossed thee here ashore, desolate, yet all undaunted, on this desert land enchanted, on this home by horror haunted, tell me truly, I implore, is there balm in Gilead? Tell me, I implore. Quoth the raven, evermore. Prophet, said I, thing of evil, prophet still, if God or devil, by that heaven that bends above us, by that God we both adore, tell this soul with sorrow laden, if within the distant Aden it shall clasp a sainted maiden, whom the angels never more clasp, the rare and greater maiden, the angel's name, the Lord. Quoth the raven, nevermore. Be that word our sign of parting, bird or fiend, I shrieked upstarting. Get thee back into the tempest and the night's plutonian shore. Leave no black plume as a token of the lie thy soul hath spoken. Leave my loneliness unbroken and quit the bust above my door. Take thy beak from out my heart and take thy form from off my door. Lamplight o'er him streaming throws my shadow on the floor, and my soul from out that shadow that lies floating on